What's up, y'all? Welcome to the Sam the Beard Guy channel. So today we are talking about IK Multimedia's MixBox. So this is one of those plugin packages. You know, honestly, if you clicked on this video, you probably already know that. So this is, they're running a deal right now. This is why they sent this to me. They're doing an 85% off deal on this. It's typically, I think, $199, and right now it's going for $29.99. And so I'm going to review this kind of plug-in thing like it's a $29 product. I would probably review it differently if it was $200, because, you know, is the value of something worth $200 versus $30? That's a very different convo. And so there are a lot of, you know, plug-in packages on the market. You know, UA's got stuff, Slate's got stuff, Waves has got stuff. I mean, there's all types. It's like every company has like a thing that they do. And so we're going to review this like it costs $30 and not $200. So if you're watching this after March 12th, you know, just take that, you know, what I say with a grain of salt, because after March 12th, this thing, I think, goes back to $200 and it's not 30 anymore. So yeah, MixBox has all your things, you know, just, yeah. So let's just get into the plugin, cause that's really what this is about. So this is MixBox. You know, like always, y'all, like, share, sub, comment, all the things, you know, because that's typically helpful. You know, I'm going to try not to sniff as much in this video. I had some complaints in the last video because I had allergies and, you know, I was sniffing a little bit and it bothered some people. So I'm going to try to sniff less in this video. You know, I live in Texas, man. It's just, it's tough year round. I was just in Arizona for a gig last weekend, and they told me that Arizona is the best place in the country to live if you have bad allergies. It's no grass, it's dry. So I don't see myself ever moving to Arizona, but it is a bummer to know that there are places out there where I could be physically happier, and I just can't move there. So that's a whole nother rant by Sam. Okay, so here's MixBox. The interface is clean. I would say, I'll pull up one plugin. You know, interfaces are kind of what they are. If you've watched this channel long enough, you know, really the product should speak for itself. I feel like the interface is a little too cute for me, but that's a personal preference. I'm kind of a minimalist in my GUI preferences. So that's not a knock on the product. That's just a personal thing. Like if I pull up some of these guys, I don't know, it's a little too cute. It's almost like too three-dimensional for me, I guess. Like you can see these are 3D. I'm starting this review off extremely nitpicky, so that's not a knock on the product. That's just a personal preference that I have. So, you know, reviewing these things can be kind of weird because it's like, you know, I'm mainly a MIDI guy that I do audio, but the whole crux of this channel is audio based, and so, or MIDI based. So I'm going to kind of change up how I play depending on what effect it is. I've recorded a little loopy loop for some of the amp modeling. And then we're going to dive into the presets too. But I kind of want to just fly through some of these options and, you know, just kind of see how they are. So here's the loopy loop. Thank you. typical amp. Yeah, so those are the amps. Again, I don't know how much these, you know, work over pianos. But, I mean, these are all straightforward. You know, I'm not a guitar player, I'm just going to be honest. So I'm sure some of these are modeled after, you know, like, I can hear the difference between an American vintage and a British tube lead. Obviously, I know what a preamp is. I know what a cab is. unfortunately, I don't play guitar, so I don't really know how to mimic this on the piano level. But, I mean, they're, again, as a $30 product, could I use one of these amps for something? Like, let's just do that. Let's pivot a little bit. Let's do... I'm pulling up some goodies. Hold on a second. Please hold. So let's pull up an Omnisphere like pad. This should be a back to this. So you could use it this way, you know, get some like, this could be a good, cool use. Yeah, that could be a cool use for that. Maybe not doing it like I did with the pianos and actually doing it through this. I don't understand why some of these, you know, or like, sometimes the presence in middle or bass or high is like turned off for a certain amp. I don't know if I'm missing a key command to turn those on or not, but like I can't, like, I don't know. Oh, you can do wet dry down here, so that's cool. So you could do, that's kind of nice. So yeah, maybe ignore the piano thing part of it and just, you know, you can use it for synths or whatever. So yeah, typical amps. Cool stuff. So channel strips. Yeah, so these are just tools, you know. It's, here's a little compressor. But honestly, what I should do here, let me keep changing. You know, this is just the way it is around here. We have some fun. And we do it live. Maybe I mute this guy and we'll do this. So this type of stuff, obviously, you know, the higher, like a low gain or mid gain is, it's going to actually engage the compressor differently. So that's a thing. So this, in a sense, is kind of a compressor. You know, you can drive the input gain and then decrease the output. Kind of. I mean, it's not entirely a compressor. But some compressors do work like this, input gain, output gain, and that's kind of what drives compression, and that's why you have peak here. You know, if I push that, bring that down, get rid of the preamp, that's compressing the crap out of it, you know? So if you have that preamp button engaged, you're getting more of that crunch. Just a different sound. So these are all like basic tools. That's cool. I could use that. It's almost like a spring verb, kind of. That's cool. That's cool. Distortion. Yeah. Okay. Maybe we should go back to this one for this. This is a bit crusher, not just a crusher. Honestly, there's better lo-fi things on the market. Yeah, so with these distortion things, you're typically running at, you know, some type of mix, dry wet, some type of balance. Let's go back to the bouncy guy. So I get this is your input into the plugin right here. Yeah, so a lot of these plugins are obviously modeled after, you know, famous, you know, if you, everyone knows what this is. So EQ... I mean, on EQ only plugins like this, I'm such a loser. Like, I typically just use the EQs I can see. You know, I like to be able to see what is, you know, too loud and mess with that. Like, you know, these dudes. I don't use Logic's compressor, but or EQ. But that's because I'm not a real mix engineer, so I sometimes need visual aids for, you know, my EQing. Filter. Let's bring this guy back. Thank you. guitar player world right there. So that's a helpful, that's a cool, yeah. These are gonna be nice. I mean, y'all know my thing on reverbs, and I have my go-tos. That's cool. I don't know why a stereo imager is in the reverb, but, you know. Yeah, these are gonna be just basic. What is it? Is it convolution or I think it's algorithmic reverb. This is what these are going to be. I think that's what it's called. And then saturation. Okay, so, you know what I didn't do any of is kind of building out an actual rack. We just kind of flew through some of these. Again, I'm evaluating this like it's a $30 plugin. I think, you know, there's enough in here at the cost of 30 bucks. It's like, why not? You know, some of the, like, I would never use EQs probably. I'm going to do that my own way. Some of these compressors are fine. Some of the distortions are fine. Some of the delays are fine. Channel strips are fine. I don't use a ton of amps given what I do, but you know, I'd be curious to see what an electric guitar player or a vocalist that would maybe use more amps. It works on the synth though, so again, at $30, sometimes things are just more of a why not than why. Some of these filters are cool. Like the white 2A, it's like if you already have the real one, then just use that. And I know that they had a free one that came out like recently. Maybe it's already come and gone. But so a lot of these are, modeled after the real thing. But again, at $30, it's like, why not? Like where did it go? Like the slicer was cool, Can you get that with other plugins? Sure. But maybe you don't have that plugin. This is kind of a why not thing. Again, I'm evaluating like it's $30. And if you're anything like me, you feel cooler when you open up your, you can't completely see it, but the more plugins you have, like someone comes over and you're like working on something and you open up your plugin list and you have thousands, like it makes you feel like no matter how talented you are or how good you are, having more gear and more software typically means you're better. And so, if you have people coming over and you want to show them how many plugins you have, this could be a $30 buy-in to that. But in all seriousness, I do think there are things here that are useful and helpful. Not all of them for me. I don't think anything about this is like, dude, I have to have this. But there are cool things. So let's get into the preset world, which I don't know where my preset tab went. How do I find, you can expand it. Nice. Here we go. Haha. Okay. So that toggles the dry wet and the, what does this do? Are these more preset? Oh. Oh, are these presets for, kind of missed that. Well, so I guess you have presets for each tube down here or each plugin. Doesn't change anything. Whatever. So let's do the global presets. There's a lot in here. So, I'm not going to, let me expand this a little bit so y'all can see some of the goodies. There's a lot to kind of flip through. We're not going to do all of them, so just chill. You get your bass. So they have all these kind of like, obviously this is not bass. But see, all three of these plugins are modeled after the real thing. So that's kind of what I mean. Like if you already have these, I don't know why you would need IK Multimedia's version of them, but whatever. So yeah, you're gonna have tons of like presets in here to get you started. I mean, the basic rule of thumb with presets, especially when you get into the mixing space and the compressor and EQ space, typically presets aren't helpful other than they're a starting place. Like, I would never record a bass and then just pull up one of these and go, yeah, basic bass, this is a basic bass, so this is good. Like, every recording is going to need its own unique touch to it. So, yeah. Thank you. Let's do this. Interesting, this is called Piano Lessons. What type of lessons are you teaching? You know, it's like, what are we doing? When I thought Piano Lessons, I thought it was going to change the piano tone to, you know, a Casio. Okay, so, yeah, let's get into the, let's go back to the synthes and do some of the That's cool. Cool, and then he, sunset sound reverb, gosh, we're just gonna, it's too much. I do like on the spaces, like the reverb stuff, it tells you if it was kind of designed as a send or an insert. I saw it here too, like, it's telling you these are for inserts, where, well, I guess if there's nothing in here that says send, I don't know why they made that distinction. But, yeah, so, you know, this one's tricky for me because, you know, I own most of the kind of stuff that these things are modeled after. And if I don't own it, it's probably because I just don't, you know, need it. You know, this, my here are my final thoughts on this. Yes, I do get, there's an affiliate link below, so I do get a commission on, you know, this $30 purchase. But let's be honest, my affiliate link is a percentage of a discounted product. So, you know, there's not enough money to be made to tempt me to deceive anybody. So what I'll say is, you know, if you're missing a lot of the these basic features, like, hey, I need a good compressor, I need, you know, some cool effects, I'm like, I've been in the box, just stock plugins forever, and I just need something, I don't have a big budget, there's no reason why this wouldn't work for you. If you are, like, a really seasoned dude or girl, that has all the plugins in the world. I mean, at $30, I mean, I remember back when, I mean, when, like, back in the day, I would, like, buy $30, like, big knob plugins, you know? And so spending $30 on even one, like, cool plugin that you might use, you know, five times a year, that's not unheard of in, like, our world where we just buy gear or buy plugins. And so at $30, you know, there's stuff in here that I could use. If I'm compressing a vocal, am I going straight to this given all the other plugins I have? Probably not. But that's me. And so I would say this is for, like, it's for two people. It is for, I only have stock plugins and I need a cheap entryway to get into just having more things. This would work. Or, hey, I'm a real seasoned professional. I have so many plugins, but it's $30 and maybe I can use some of these things, you know, a handful of times a year. Those are really who it's for, my opinion, my perspective. And so I'll let you take from that what you want to. I don't think there's anything about this product that's inherently bad. There's just so many of these types of products on the market. You have to make sure that you're in the right camp to justify getting this. And so as a $30 product, it's either, hey, this is super helpful, or, well, why not? You know? And that's really, I think, who this is geared for. At $30, I might have bought this, you know, or I would buy it just because, you know, why not? Like, maybe one day I want a different sounding thing, or I just want to find a preset that's working and just get moving. And so that's my take. That's my stance on this. I'm grateful they sent it to me. It was fun to kind of play through. Yeah. Hit me with comments in the bottom if you're like, dude, I hated this. Or, you know, I feel like I only sniffled like 5 times, maybe 10. So feel free to comment on that too. Like, hey, good job, less sniffing. Or it's like, man, still, like 10 times is 10 times too many. You know, just let me know. So, all right. Thank y'all for watching, and I will see y'all later.